A man abandoned a dog in a field. When rescuers found out the truth, they were angry. Dogs have the capability of lightening our moods and lightening up our world. They are the most loyal and cuddly creatures in the world who reciprocate our love 1,000 times more than what we give them. They are sensitive and great playmates. Their presence can be really relaxing. However, sometimes, even against their wishes, some people keep themselves ahead of their pets. And there are some people who don't even respect these creatures. They abandon them without thinking of the consequences or caring how things would end up. Today, we're going to tell you the story of one such dog which is irresponsibly abandoned, not only by its owner, but also after that. There are some people who don't like dogs, and that's okay. Well, no, it isn't. But those people who are attached to dogs or just like their nature know how selflessly giving these creatures can be. It is an understatement that they love you unconditionally. Dogs have proven to be companions for people going through depression and help them get out of it. They are appointed in court so that they can calm a person who is anxious about taking the stand, such as the effect of their company. A dog is like a family member, just that they're more lovable. But sometimes, some people take their presence for granted and it really affects those creatures. And obviously, we know how they've helped the police crack a number of cases. The animals who've previously had homes and abandoned after that are called owner surrenders. There are various reasons why people simply abandon their beloved pets without thinking things through. At times, pets get sick and infected, and owners think abandoning them is the only solution, not knowing that most diseases are manageable. Some owners leave their pets as they are sick of taking care of them, which is horrifying, right? People don't realize the need of advanced planning their pet family, and therefore their pets end up in shelters. But one of the most common reasons why people abandon their animals is when they're moving to another place. It is a lot of paperwork, and some places don't even allow pets to be transported to. But moving in is most often only an excuse. Sometimes behavioral problems are the reasons for abandonment, but people lack the knowledge that most behavioral issues can be taken care of. The brunt of being left out or thrown out of a loving home is faced by the pets. In the shelters, it has been found that dogs who were previously loved and abandoned grow secluded and untrustworthy of any attention they get. Dogs believe themselves to be unworthy as they were abandoned. This further affects their chances of being further adopted. They don't mingle a lot with other dogs, and the old ones don't even get to leave the shelter. They develop what we humans call an inferiority complex, and the cases of depressed dogs are not unknown. This is a story of one such dog. It was sheer luck that Alan Webster of the South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance Service was in the neighborhood that day. He and his team were out on a fundraising at the car boot on the day that they found something heart-wrenching at it, at 5 a.m. in the morning. It was supposed to be a regular day, but it turned out saddening and angering all the people who saw what happened. Of course, Alan, soft-hearted as he was when it came to animals, took it upon himself to take care of who they found abandoned that morning near the bushes. Things did not make sense, and the animal should not have been there in the first place. And it was sheer luck that they happened to be at the site of the incident. What would have happened otherwise, there is no knowing. South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance Service is a 24-hour pet ambulance service for pets, and they also make street rescues. It is a non-profit service working only with the help of funds and donations, and they're open all the time. They welcome rescuers and volunteers, and their Facebook page regularly puts up animals for adoptions, which they've managed to rescue and provide shelter for. Some members, along with the founder Alan Webster, were in an area, ready to set up a fundraiser in a car boot when near it. At 5 a.m. in the morning, they found something they didn't expect. In the field, the company found an abandoned and shivering terrier who, by the looks of it, was not quite young, but wasn't diseased or ill either. They didn't know the name of the terrier yet, nor who it belonged to. They just knew it was abandoned, as it was indicated by the stuff lying around it. Alan Webster believes that in the past few months, the British people have grown more insensitive. It was a female terrier, cold and wet, and Alan said, "We had a little cooker and we made her some rice pudding, which really warmed her up. I was gonna have it for my breakfast." The terrier, however, was not alone. The terrier was tied to the boot of the car that the South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance Service was going to use for the fundraiser, and the person who abandoned the terrier behind the bush had also left a bag of food, water in a bowl, a blanket, and a few other things which seemed to be its belongings. When Alan approached the terrier, he found that her name was Tessa. For the time being, he focused on getting her warm and well-fed because the terrier seemed to have been out in the cold for some time. All he had was anger and hatred for the person who abandoned the dog. He wondered what would have happened to Tessa if he or his crew members had not reached there or had come a little late. His hatred increased when he found that the person had left a note. Terriers do not shed hair. That means their hair can keep growing like that of humans. Since they do not shed, there is a lot less fuss. Terriers make funny noises. When sneezing, they gasp for air instead of letting it out and make a honk sound like a goose. It's just cute, nothing harmful or worrisome about it. Even though they're small and weigh only up to 7 pounds, they are brave dogs, capable of taking on animals much larger in size. Why would someone abandon a dog like this? The note is anonymous and tried to explain why the person abandoned Tessa. Apparently, Tessa was left forcefully to the care of this person who was trusted with her by her neighbor who went to Canada. Alan personally believed that the neighbor going to Canada was a lie, and the person who'd written the note was the actual owner, who was now tired of taking care of Tessa as she was growing old. When they dug deeper into the case, they found something else. The note did not end there, it went on providing justifications. When Alan read it, he responded, "He's just dumped her at the car boot, it was wrong." The note, after giving Tessa's name and age, went on to say that Tessa had been put up to her care by his neighbor, who was leaving for Canada, and he reluctantly took charge of her, but he knew from the beginning that he was not going to keep Tessa. The question that arises is, why did he agree to take care of her then? Maybe the neighbor would have found someone who actually loved dogs and didn't mind having one in their home. Alan, in his anger, questioned, "What if we hadn't been there for whatever reason that morning? He used us as an excuse." The note did not end there. The note went on to give instructions about Tessa's likes as far as food was concerned. She likes tea, coffee, and watered milk and takes her first meal after 11:30 a.m. These were probably the instructions that this anonymous person got from the owner of Tessa on how to take care of her. The neighbor clearly trusted this person to take good care of Tessa, but he betrayed her trust by abandoning her dog. It was later found that there was an owner who, when she found out how her dog had been treated, burst into tears as she thought she was leaving Tessa behind in good hands. The note ended by saying, "Sorry for the above, I don't need a dog." How a person can assume that a sorry might make up for the trauma and abandonment that he made a loved dog go through is something incomprehensible. A note scribbled with food preferences is not an adequate or even a proper substitute for the love and attention Tessa deserved. South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance made the photos and the note accompanying it viral, and then they got a response from the actual owner, which they now knew existed. Their response to the post was as expected, that of anger and outrage. When the South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance posted this online, the post received a lot of outrage. It read, "Some scumbag has dumped this dog behind the bush in Old Coat's car boot. We arrived here at 5 a.m. in the morning to find him tied up and laying on a wet bed, not chipped and obviously in need of a home." People reacted angrily to the post, unable to believe that someone would abandon a dog like this. The post was also brought to the attention of the real owner's son, and when he informed his mother about the whole incident, she was heartbroken. It was found out that the real owner of Tessa was a 76-year-old woman named Yvonne Radcliffe, who had requested her neighbor to look after Tessa for some time as she was going to move to Canada. The neighbor and Yvonne Radcliffe had known each other for over 9 years, so naturally she trusted him with her dog, whom she considered her family. It was actually through her 38-year-old son, Paul Edwardson, that the real owner's identity came forward, as he was the one who informed her, having come across the post about Tessa on the internet. When contacted, Paul Edwardson said, "I'm upset, but I'm more angry if I'm being honest. Tessa was 12 and my mother feared that she may not survive the flight. She came back to the UK for 6 weeks to sort out her possessions, but primarily rehomed Tess. Mum was worried where Tess would go and didn't want her to go to a stranger. She'd known that neighbor for over 9 years and he told her that he had always wanted a dog." He went on to express his outrage at the neighbor's betrayal. Paul Edwardson continued, "The neighbor had told my mum that he was building a run for her and was so happy to have her. When I rang my mum and told her, she immediately started crying her eyes out. She kept repeating, 'What has happened to my dog?' There's been no remorse from the neighbor at all. There has to be much tougher punishments for this kind of offense." He is right there. There should be tough punishments for people who abandon dogs and other pets. Meanwhile, what happened with Tessa? People from all around came to support Tessa, and South Yorkshire Pet Ambulance Service got a lot of calls regarding Tessa's information so that she can be adopted. They were so outraged that they issued this statement, Shame on the woman who went to live in Canada, and shame on the bloke who tied up and dumped an elderly dog in a field with the expectation of someone finding her. However, when they got to know about the owner's point of view, they issued an apology and given a head is Tessa's adoption post. Even if that heartless neighbor gave up on Tessa much to the owner's dismay, the Yorkshire Pet Service did not. They put out this post and some of the comments on it go like this. Having your trust smashed like that? How horrible! Tessa's owner is a 76-year-old woman who trusted her dear friend with her beloved pooch. She loved Tessa so much, she left her rather than risk her not surviving the plane ride. Her heart must have been breaking. There were other such comments too. Another person commented on the same post, "Personally, I'm disgusted that this has happened, nor would I ever put a beloved family pet through this. I live on a farm in Cumbria and we already have a few dogs, some working outdoor and one house dog. Depending on Tessa's comfort around other dogs, I would be happy to take her in. Such a shame." But it is not over for Tessa. Thankfully, she's found a temporary but loving place. Tessa is currently at the Netherlands Kennels, located in Rotherham, England, and waiting for the right person or family to adopt her. She is happy and healthy and has adapted well to her new environment. Maybe it was for the best that she found a place like this. It is better than to be in the care of someone who didn't even want her. Her owner, however, would be regretting now not to have taken her along.